She's gone, she said. She went to be with him. I know it. How can she do this? She's supposed to be at Yale in 2 weeks. Margaret, my father said, squinting at the note. Calm down. The M was Cass's boyfriend, Adam. He was 21, had a goatee, and lived in New York working on the Lamont Whipper show. It was one of those shock talk shows where people tell their boyfriends they've been sleeping with their best friends, and guests routinely include Klansmen and 80-pound 4-year-olds. Adam's job mostly consisted of getting coffee, picking up people at the airport, and pulling guests off each other during the frequent fights that scored the big show ratings. Since she'd come home from the beach 3 weeks ago, she'd met Adam there. Cass had been glued to the TV each day at 4 p.m., wishing aloud for a good fight just so she could catch a glimpse of him. Usually she did, smiling at the sight of him charging on stage, his face serious, to untangle 2 scrapping sisters or a couple of rowdy cross-dressers. My father put the note down on the table and walked to the phone. I'm calling the police, he said, and my mother burst into tears again, her hands rising to her face. Over her shoulder, through the glass door and over the patio, I could see our neighbors, Boo and Stuart Connell. They were cutting through the tree line that separated our houses for my birthday brunch. Boo had a bouquet of fresh-cut zinnias, bright and colorful, in her hand. I just can't believe this, my mother said to me, pulling out a chair and sitting down at the table. She was shaking her head. What if something happens to her? She's only 18. Yes, hello. I'm calling to report a missing person, my father said suddenly in his official dean of students' voice. Cassandra O'Corrin. Yes, she's my daughter. I had a sudden memory pop into my head. My mother standing in the doorway of Cass's and my childhood bedroom, back when we had twin beds and pink wallpaper. She would always kiss us, then stand in the doorway after turning off the light, her shadow stretching down the length of the room between us. She was always the last thing I tried to see before I fell asleep. See you in Dreamland, she'd whisper, and blow a kiss before shutting the door quietly behind her. Like Dreamland was a real place, tangible, where we would all wander close enough to catch glimpses and brush shoulder. I always went to sleep determined to go there, to find her and Cass, and sometimes I did, but it was never the way I imagined it would be. Now my mother sat weeping as my father reported Cass's vital statistics. 5'4", brown hair, brown eyes, mole on the left cheek. And I had the sudden sinking feeling that Dreamland might be the only place we'd be seeing her for a while. I heard a knock and looked up to see Boo and Stuart standing on the patio waving at us. They'd been our neighbors for as long as I could remember, since before Cass or I was even born. They were former hippies, now New Agers. They believed in massage, fresh This will be your best year yet. I can feel it. Don't count on it, I said, as she pulled back and frowned at me, confused, just as my father hung up the phone and cleared his throat. Technically, he said, they can't do anything for 24 hours, but they're keeping an eye out for her. We need to call all of our friends right now. Maybe she told someone something. What's going on? Boo asked. And at the table, my mother just shook her head. She couldn't even say it. Margaret, what is it? It's Cassandra, my father told her, his voice flat. It appears that she's run away. This was my father, always formal. He lived for supposedlys and theoretically's, not believing anything without proper proof. Oh my God, said Boo, pulling out a chair and yanking it close to my mother before sitting down. Where did she go? I don't know, my mother said softly. And Boo took one of her hands, rubbing the fingers with her own, as Stuart moved to stand behind her, his hand on her shoulder. They were touchy people, always had been. My father, however, was not, so neither made a move toward him. My mother sniffled. I don't know anything. Caitlin, my father said to me briskly, get a list together of our friends, anyone she might have talked to, and the number for that Whitner show, or whatever it's called. Okay, I said, not bothering to correct him. He nodded before turning back to my mother and Boo and Stuart to look out across the patio at the few squirrels crowding the bird feeders. On my way back to my room, I picked up my present from where? It was lying in the middle of the hallway. It was wrapped with blue paper.